Well, hello there, I'm Green Deane, and welcome to my 47th video here at EatTheWeeds.com. Today we're going to talk about the Apios Americana. These little fellas, you know, they're pretty hard to misidentify. And you know why? Because they look like this. Let's go take a look at them.
If you're going to go out in the field in just a moment and see me dig these up, I want to show them to you in a clean situation. As you can see, these are swellings along one root, and it branches, and you can see these are all the tubers or swellings in the root. Apios Americana. I want you to notice the environment that I'm in. This is a small stream here in central Florida. It's a trail across the stream. Actually, this is where the horses cross. And as you can see, there's a lot of seepage here. We have a lot of springs here in Florida. And over here I have found one of the prime foraging foods in America. And that's the groundnut. I've got a couple of demonstrations here, but this is a string of groundnuts. Let's see if I can... Now these are small, so I'll just take these home and plant them. But there's a large one in the end. But I've also uncovered... Well, here's just one. As a matter of fact, I can show you the... I might plant this. This is the branch that still, plant it still came from. But down here, if we can go get a better look, matter of fact, I'll get my trowel and get down here. Here's what I want you to see. I follow the root here, and if you can see, there's one, two, three, four ground nuts here. They're about the size of an egg. It broke. But we'll take it now once we pull it out. I think there's any more. Oh, there's another one after that. Okay, I'll have to turn this off and dig a bit more. Well, what we have here is the classic groundnut, or Apios Americana. Perhaps we should call it that. As you can tell, it grows on the roots. This is the older one. And there goes an osprey. Yeah, up in the tree there. So, as you can see, here's the oldest that goes out. And I don't know if you can tell on this one. See the little white spot there? That's some latex slipping, seeping out from another root. And this is a new rootlet's going out with five or six on there. Here's an example of it branching. You can see, here we go. And over here, there's a branching on it. And to give you a perspective, there's my trowel. It's a bent 4-inch trowel, I believe. Now, this one is really large. You normally don't see them that size. They're normally about this size. But they are a prime foraging food in North America. The one other thing I want to mention about this environment is if you come here after heavy rain, or where your groundnuts are, you can see the vines coming down, and when a heavy rain can come through or wash it out, you can actually uncover some of the groundnuts. Over there, there's a string of groundnuts exposed simply by the washing action of the water. So it does pay to go look around after a rain to find some groundnuts. The one disconcerting thing you might find about Apios Americana is it can resemble poison ivy. But if you look carefully on the stem, for example, where can I find? Here we go. Now, that kind of looks like poison ivy, doesn't it? But you'll notice the stems are not equal length, whereas in poison ivy they tend to be. So you've got a very, very long stem and a terminal leaf, and then two very short stems here for your side leaves, and they're actually perpendicular. But if you look also, you'll notice in the same vine, there are five leaflets on the leaf. So there we go. Poison ivy doesn't have five. So we have fives and threes here. So that's your good identifying characteristic. And it's a very wiry vine. It's got a lot of strength to it. So there is your Apios Americana vine.
I'll have you know, I got my very first case of poison ivy digging up Apios, because Apios and the poison ivy like the same damp environment. Here on Eat the Weeds we itemize, so let's itemize the Apios Americana. Identification. You know, the Apios is pretty hard to misidentify because, well, it looks like this. You've got a string of brown beads on it, and it branches. And they can be quite long, but you're going to have several of them. Now, they can also be smaller. The first year will be a lot smaller, and they'll be tan. The second year, they'll be larger and dark colored like this. And it takes 2 years to get a root crop out of them. If you were to cut the root or the stem, a white latex sticky sap comes out. And yes, I said a white latex sap. It's one of the few plants that has white sap that we can eat after cooking. Above ground, the Apios bears a superficial resemblance to the poison ivy. The Apios is a long vine. It has leaflets of 3, 5, and 7. Of course, the poison ivy does not have leaflets of 5 or 7. But the leaflets of 3 do resemble the poison ivy, except the two lateral leaves have got very short petioles, and the terminal leaf has got a very long petiole. The flowers are brown purple, very fragrant. I think they smell like lilacs. Other people think they smell like violets, but they do have a strong aroma to them. And it has a pea pod, little flat seeds in there, and the flat seeds are edible if you shell them and boil them. Time of year. Well, roots anytime, pea pods in the fall. It's a two-year crop. The first year puts out a little runner with just little tiny, tiny, light brown, tan bumps on it. And the second year is when they actually swells up and make an edible root. Those swellings are about egg size, although they can get larger. As a matter of fact, I've got a good size one here. They can get much bigger. Here in Florida, I find them around small brooks. That's the easiest place for me to find them. Elsewhere in North America, you know, any body of water will do. But they do like the same place as poison ivy. And what I do is, I carry around with me a particular soap. If you go to the grocery stores and you look down in the laundry section, way down the bottom shelf, there's usually a large bar of soap that has naphtha in it. It's always in my backpack, and whenever I get exposed to poison ivy, I use that naphtha-based soap wash-up, and I haven't had poison ivy in a long time, so I think it's perhaps because of that soap. Now, as far as poison ivy, everybody's going to get poison ivy at some time or another if they have enough exposure to it. And incidentally, I mean, there are no people immune to poison ivy. And incidentally, only man and monkeys can get poison ivy. Method of preparation. You have to cook the roots. You can either boil them, slice them up and fry them, and I've heard some people baking them, although I have never baked them. But you must cook them thoroughly. And if you do cook them in a pan, make sure it's not an aluminum pan, because the latex and the roots do not go well, mix well with aluminum. One caution here is that some people have a very strong reaction to the Apios, an allergic reaction. Perhaps it's to undercooking, perhaps it's to the latex. Some people can actually eat them for several years and then develop an allergy or response to them, which may be something to do with undercooking and the latex, but be careful about that. I want to thank you for joining me here in my 47th video on EatTheWeeds.com, and this time about the Apios Americana or the groundnut. If you want to know more about the groundnut, go to EatTheWeeds.com, and there you can read an article about them and about 115 other wild edible plants. So until next time, this is Green Deane. I want you to think green. I want you to eat green. And sometimes that includes a string of brown, delicious little tubers called the Apios Americana groundnut. Toodles.